March playoff football has come to the west coast of Florida, and we are at Raymond James Stadium here in Tampa. Coming up, it's the final game of Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a good NFC matchup in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Winner go home is the mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC Wild Card game. This one taken just inside the 10. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. There's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. Now he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 39 yards there, a big one. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
Let's get off the field, D. Let's get off the field, D. Joker.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. A 24-yard touchdown as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
Remember what
he told us?
Absolutely.
With some teams, I script to probe in the early part of the game. Other teams, I script to attack. They've been in attack mode for these ball games and continue that in this one.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team. Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 15. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage.
Brandon, one thing about blitzes, they really confuse offensive linemen at times. And what you have to do is lock in on the guy right in front of you. If you don't, you saw the end result. Defensive tackle ended up making the play.
And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Sometimes your philosophies get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first two plays. It didn't amount to much.
And now facing a 3rd and long at the outset of this drive. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. First down, Seattle, 16 yards the gain there. First down. From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Now it's Carson. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's 2nd down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Troy Apke, and they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, This one's going the other way.
They'll start out on the ground with Jones. He's got the first down and more inside the 40. And down to the 27-yard line. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. Well, they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
That's now a pair of explosive plays in succession, both north of 20 yards. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Get your backs to the goal line. I can hear my high school coach right now. This is when force meets force. Got to be physical in order to win this battle.
Yeah, that's where the physicality pays off. A nice job forcing the contact and forcing the incompletion.
Yeah, Coach Ford would have loved that play.
And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the five here, brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
Here's Jones, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Taking it in from 4 yards out as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. First quarter touchdown run. Remember this coming on the heels of his NFC Offensive Player of the Week performance that was so great last week.
Did you feel the rumble all the way up here?
Well, the big bodies up front.
Big bodies moving people, and him, of course, charging through those great holes that were created.
Off to a great start here. Maybe looking for award number two, adding to the award that he won last week in the NFC. This fielded at the two. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that zero off the board. Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. Past the 20, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Tyler Lockett, 78 yards, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Myers connects on the PAT, and that'll make our score 14-7. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And Brady's throw there, incomplete.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10.
Check the hot read. Watch the safety creep. Hey,
Jones. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. Getting the sense Charles are going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Hey, Alpha.
From the gun on third down, Brady. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty. And it's fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Can't ask for much more than that. A 50-yard punt followed by a loss on the return. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've been a come-from-behind team all year. They'll need to do it again as they trail early in this wild card game. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Clock runs, less than a minute to go, and an entertaining first quarter of play. To throw again on second down, Wilson, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Even the greats in this game, and he certainly qualifies as one of them, they're going to have trouble if they continue to throw into double coverage.
He better be careful throwing into too much double. Looking for the tight end, Olsen, and it's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And he will bring this down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line. They had him back deep, got the interception, and now they start inside the 10.
Partner forgets starting inside the red zone. They're inside the green zone. From the 10-yard line in, a lot of teams call it that. Because that's the money zone. Get it into the end zone and make your cash.
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. They'll try again on second and goal after going backwards to the 12. This is Jones. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about three. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. Boy, you'd hate to squander this great field position. Here's third and goal. Brady. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Jarvis Landry there to make the grab as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and it's now 21-7. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. First down, Seattle, 16 yards the gain there.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 11 yards there and a first down for Seattle.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And Wilson's going to be intercepted a third time. It's Devin White, the linebacker. 20! And he will score! Touchdown, Tampa Bay!
From what we just saw, that's a great example of a team that was really amped up. They've been playing so well, yet they didn't get overexcited and have a bust on defense and gave up a big play. Instead, they created their own big play with a pick six. This one may be over.
Yeah, it's just the first half, but that lead has swelled to the point where you're wondering if it is over already. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they have nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Brandon, if I'm an offensive coordinator and I see an all-out rush like that, I file it away because I'm going to use their aggressiveness against them as this game goes on. I'm going to hit them with a screen soon.
Second down, here's Penny. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, the offensive line.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the linebacker, Demario Davis. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
The Bucs on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. He finds his target. It's Evans. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
Wait, that 5-20. Watch the curl, watch the curl, watch the curl. Hey, Alabama.
On first down, Brady. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So the penalty certainly helps them out as they come up on second and five. Brady to throw again. His throw caught at about the five. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
I know we just saw a nice throw and catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time? Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Hey, set, wait 20. Check, check, watch 54, watch 54. Hey.
Right there.
Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. This is caught. Gronkowski. No gain there on the completion. It'll be second down. Another shot from the one on second and goal. They'll try to run it in with Jones. And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones with his second touchdown here in this first half. As the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. Gay is on for the point after. And he's been a busy man. 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Ed One told me once, you know, we were having a tough patch. This too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally we kept having a rough patch. He said, but you got to do something.
Heads up. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 40.
Okay, baby, let's go. Let's go.
Coming up at the half, we remind you that we're going to do what we've done all year. We'll get you down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. Coach will have the lowdown on what's going on here in this wild card weekend as we begin the road to the upcoming Super Bowl. They try and run on first down, but this one going to lose a couple yards as they get him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and it'll be second and 12.
Hey, Steve Six.
From the gun, it's Brady. And his throw here is incomplete. Quentin Dunbar right there on the coverage.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Brady. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
We said it before the game, and I think it's still apparent. If these guys are going to advance in these playoffs, they're going to have to wreak some havoc coming off the edge.
Yeah, wild card round. They told us the wild card could be that defensive pressure. They showed it there. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. And that is very well done there as this will be marked out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone. They need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Now Wilson down around his goal line. And that will be incomplete. I hate to sound really negative, but at this point, an incomplete pass, almost a moral victory that it's not picked off.
Well, you may hate to sound negative, but that was negative.
It was very negative, I know. But all these first half interceptions, it's been tough to watch.
Yeah, couldn't find a silver lining in this one. Much more like lead.
Wilson and the offense not coming off the field. They're going for it on fourth. Boy, and now they can't even get a playoff. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Looks like the offense is going to take another shot here. They're going on fourth and 13. Now it's Wilson. In trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone loose. And what else could go wrong at this point? This is going to be a defensive touchdown as they keep piling it on. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. And the route is on here in this first half. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down, and it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops, and if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
So we come upon halftime here in this NFC wild card matchup as we send you a stone's throw away across I-4 to Orlando. There standing by is Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? Two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Levante David. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. So after the INT, it's Brady. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The linebacker, Bobby Wagner, able to get back in coverage and knock it free. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10. Jones. And an alley to run. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones saving his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown. interception by the Bucs D leads to a touchdown. Gay is on for the point after. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 6. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Devin White leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of 6.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 6. And the pressure gets to him again.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in 3rd and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
3rd and long, it's Wilson. And they've got the hookup. This is Olsen. And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a 4th down. And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it.
Let's put that team on the bus.
They'll indeed go for it with Wilson. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 30, and they will take over at the 29-yard line. The number 7, usually lucky here, not for him. 7 picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened 6 times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he won a Heisman Trophy in college, so sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career, but when you're talking about 1 game, 7, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw 7 picks. That's a big loss of 3, and it brings up 3rd down. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is 3rd and long. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. The 3rd down run gets them nothing. Now they couldn't get anything going there out on the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the passing game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
This one is right down Broadway. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead grows even further. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just 3.
Well, getting the 3 turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach when he ordered the field goal, please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. so even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
This throw complete, Wilson finding Lockett. His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right now,
and he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. Shaquille Barrett leading the surge there as he drops him for a loss of six. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Wilson toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And that is incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time. Here we go on fourth with Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaquille Barrett and the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Watch out.
They'll run it with Jones. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 10 yards there and a Buccaneer first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And they keep on the ground with Jones. 18 yards that time to push him up first and goal.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop it. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The three red zone trips, three touchdowns so far. They'll look for a fourth on second and goal. A give to Jones. And he will maneuver his way down to about the seven. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 4 yards on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal. Now this time, Brady will throw. And he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Jarvis Landry, two catches, two touchdowns here so far, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and that will extend this big lead. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And he will be marked down right there at the 20-yard line. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. it's Wilson. Complete to Dorsett. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Absolutely nobody fooled there. He's going nowhere fast as he stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Up front, the struggles continue for this offense among the line. What can they do? Change the play calling? What?
I think part of that, yes, changing some of the play calls, some screens, some draws, some misdirection. You want to run any type of a play that will influence these guys to continue to get upfield and find a way to use that against them and slip things in behind them. So some quick passes could work as well.
His second catch of this wild card game, and it goes for a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Tight end Ringo. Tight end on Ringo. Tight
end. On first and 10, it's Wilson. Dorsett making the catch. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Philip Dorsett, 54 yards. And the Seahawks are able to at least knock this deficit down a bit. But look, this is a team, Charles. They faced adversity all year long. They had to fight and claw to win that division. But they're putting it all together here in the wild card game.
Feels like a statement, doesn't it? An absolute statement game. A message to the top seeds. Overlook us at your own peril. We're pretty darn good.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on 3 games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. We you know, these guys play, and we just play them all the way through. Now, in certain situations, they will take them out, but for the most part, they're not as worried and concerned about getting them out of the game. And that's always puzzled me a little bit.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big run there by Jones. 46 yards on the ground. So it's Buccaneer football as we welcome you back. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. They follow up that gigantic gain with the tiniest of pickups, 1 yard. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Running right, Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A gain of 2 there on the heels of a 1-yard pickup on first.
Well, they had that one sniffed out. Excellent run blitz. Stopped that one for a short gain.
What makes a good run blitz a good run blitz?
The ability to stay on task, to follow up your assignment, go to the gap you're supposed to cover, and not be deterred by anything else.
And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.